glad to have you join me again this week. We're on the third floor of the beautiful State Capitol building and have just stepped off the floor. We've had several hours of floor session. We're taking a break for caucus and we're going back in. I will share with you something really fun that happened today. I had the opportunity to have lunch with the governor. It was a very small group, two of his staff, some friends of ours from the Autism Society of Minnesota. And the reason we were there was Miss Minnesota. Miss Minnesota chose as her topic for her reign at autism. She has a brother that has Asperger's, which is on the autism spectrum. And so she feels very passionately about it and asked to speak with the governor and a few of the legislators who are carrying bills concerning autism. I will say Senator Nelson from Rochester was the other legislator. She came late into the meeting, but she was there too. There were only two of us that were able to attend or were invited, and we had a really wonderful opportunity to speak with the governor and Miss Minnesota about her passion, which is autism. Might be worth saying that there are several autism pieces of legislation that some of us have been carrying, having to do with housing and having to do with studying the incidence of autism. And one of the things I'm quite pleased about is there is still some language in there to study the types of therapies that are most effective. Those pieces are in the Health and Human Service Omnibus Bill, which we're caucusing right now, and I need to step in there in just a moment, and will be heard on the floor this evening. The bill has some concerning components, as all omnibus bills do, but I would say, by and large, it's a bill that, with a little bit of work, certainly can get the signature of the House and Senate and go to the governor after its conference. So I'm quite hopeful that that will be one of the bills that will make its way to the governor's desk. All depends upon what folks are willing to pull out of that bill in order to gain the governor's signature. So, as I mentioned, we're going to go back into the House session this evening. We're going to take up that Health and Human Service omnibus bill and perhaps a few other bills, as we've already begun to do today. I'm hopeful one of my bills on the volunteer dentist situation at Salvation Army is going to come up, maybe not today, but tomorrow. And I'm pleased to have had a bill hearing in Health and Human Service Finance just a few hours ago here at the Capitol concerning the Nurse Licensure Compact, which has been covered in our local paper, and I'm sure you know is very, very important to Mayo Clinic, many of the hospitals and nurses across the state of Minnesota. We have yet to gain the governor and his department's support for that, but I've asked for another meeting with the governor, and perhaps we can bring him along and get that bill passed this session. So that's a quick highlight of what's happened this week here at the Capitol, and I'll be happy to share a little bit more next week, which may be our last week or second to the last week. We are winding down. Bonding bills are moving through. Mayo Civic Center's in the Senate bonding bill, not in the House, so there's some conferencing that needs to happen, but things are looking up for Rochester. Until next time.